this kind of video is really hurting the hobby, and I can't understate this. This could hurt it so bad that no one will ever know what the truth is, because everybody's watching videos on their phones and TikTok videos. I mean, that's what you see. Everyone's watching stuff, and they catch stuff like this, and they'll never know the truth because they won't go buy the book. They won't watch good videos because these kind of videos end up going viral. Everybody wants to think that what they've gotten or change is worth a lot of money. But this video I'm going to do a review of, it is not even, I mean, it's so ridiculous. I mean, you have to laugh even though this is not funny at all, honestly. But I might, because it's so ridiculous. I just want to play it. I'm going to do a review. What's really upsetting and very difficult, a lot of people think, well, you're just jealous because you didn't get the views. No, it's not that. I already did the video and happened to look at the channel and see that 3 months ago this video was released, and it's already received 114,000 views. Do you know how many videos I've released in 3 months, and only one of them has made it over 100,000 views? Only one. People don't want the education. I mean, I know other channels that put out plenty of education. I literally try to educate, but people want to hear this. I mean, I could put a video out about 4 ultra-rare most valuable quarters. They're using artificial intelligence, promoting the video, or whatever they're doing to get people to watch it. People see these coins, and you got to watch the video. You just got to watch this review of this video. It's unbelievable. You won't believe it. Just play it, and I'll have some commentary. Let's get to watching this a little bit.
Welcome back to our channel. Today, we've got an exciting topic for you, the top 5 quarter dollar coin. We'll be exploring their historical significance and current market values. Let's get started. I've got a handful of these 1,974 quarters here, and
1,009, you've got 5 quarters, but I want you to notice something about these quarters. Okay, somebody wore gloves, but yet these quarters have tape residue on them and some type of debris. I don't know where. This must have been from another country or something. I don't know. I'm not showing the channel. I'm not advertising this channel. If you want to find it, that's fine. But I just wanted to point that out.
We're going to uncover the secrets behind their value. The 1970s were a fascinating time for coinage, with some interesting quirks. The absence of a mint mark on coins from this era can be attributed to the Philadelphia Mint, where coins were produced without the mint mark during certain years. Now, let's talk about the factors that influence the value of our 1974 quarter dollar without a mint mark. Condition, rarity, and demand, these factors play a crucial role. A well-preserved coin in mint condition will naturally fetch a higher value. Yeah. Rarity is key, and of course, if there's a growing demand among collectors, the value can soar. To gain further insights, I spoke with a coin expert. Let's hear what they have to say. The 1974 quarter dollar without a mint mark is indeed a sought-after piece among collectors. Its scarcity and historical significance contribute to its allure.
Oh my gosh.
Condition is paramount, so if you have one in excellent shape, you're in luck.
No.
The value of a 1974 quarter dollar without a mint mark can range from $95,000 to $100,500, depending on the factors we discussed earlier. Keep in mind that prices may fluctuate, so it's always a good idea to check with reputable coin dealers or online resources for the latest updates. Next up, we have...
Yeah, check with a reputable dealer. He talked with an expert. An expert told him that that's worth tens of thousands of dollars. Can't even say it right because it's obviously AI generated. Didn't even try to edit it. What do you got to say about the 1966? I can't imagine.
Let's talk about the 1966 D quarter dollar. They'd mint mark indicates that these coins were minted at the Denver Mint.
Yes.
Now, why is this specific year and mint mark so intriguing? Well, there are...
What is that right there on that nasty debris? It looks like it's out of a cup holder.
A few factors that contribute to its value. 1966 marked a transitional period in U.S. coinage. The country was moving away from silver-based coins, and the 1966 quarter is one of the first-clad coins composed of copper nickel over a pure copper core. Understanding this historical context adds an extra layer of significance to these coins.
Not a 66. 65 is, I know they minted silver coins all the way up into you know, I think 66 or 67, but they were all dated 64. 65 is actually the transitional year. 66 is not significant whatsoever.
Next, let's talk about mintage numbers. Mintage plays a crucial role in determining a coin's rarity and potential value. While the 1966 quarter isn't considered ultra-rare, the limited mintage of coins from this period can contribute to their desirability among collectors. As with any coin, the condition is a key factor.
Okay, what was that? Did you see that? Let's see if I can back it up a little bit here. Did you see that? Here, look here. I was editing this and I noticed this. There is a fly or something that hit the quarter. It looks like it has red and yellow wings, and it literally smacks the quarter and comes back. Look at that. What in the world? I just caught a flash that I couldn't. There's the eye. Can you see it? I think that's the eyes, wings. Wow, that's different.
In determining its value, coins in mint condition or with minimal wear and tear tend to fetch higher prices in the collector's market. If you have a well-preserved 1966 D quarter, it could be more valuable than you think. The value of coins can fluctuate based on demand and market conditions. Research recent sales and auctions. The value of a 1966 D quarter dollar without a mint mark can range from $89,000 to $150,500, depending on the factors we discussed earlier. Consider seeking opinions from coin experts or professional appraisers. Their expertise...
Why don't you consider... how about you consider going to an expert and a coin appraiser, a real one, and stop harvesting this information? Man, this is... No wonder people come in the coin shop asking or thinking and calling up on the shop that they actually think just because someone could do a video or a video is on YouTube that is legit. This is not legit. This coin's worth a quarter, 25 cents, period. I wish I could put that out in every single language.
These can provide valuable insights into the specific nuances of the 1966 D quarter and help you understand its true market value. At number three, let's talk about the significance of the 1977 quarter dollar without a mint mark. These coins were produced at the Philadelphia Mint, and they hold a unique place in numismatic history. Now, let's explore their value. Before we get into the value, it's essential to understand the historical context. The absence of a mint mark indicates that the coin was minted in Philadelphia.
Correct.
In 1977, the U.S. Mint did not place mint marks on coins produced at the Philadelphia Mint, making these coins distinctive.
No.
Several factors influenced the value of a quarter dollar from 1977 without a mint mark. The coin's condition, rarity, and overall demand in the collector's market play a crucial role.
Yeah, repeat.
Let's break it down. Now, the big question, what's the value of a 1977 quarter dollar without a mint mark? Well, as of my last knowledge update in January 2022, these coins could range from a $200,000 for circulated ones to potentially more for well-preserved specimens. At number three, let's talk about the 19...
No. Oh, my goodness. This is nuts. What's the value? Let's skip ahead here. It's going to say the same thing over and over. So they're going up in value for each one of them. The
value could be significantly higher, reaching $300,000, $500 or more.
$500.
Last but not least, the 1985 P-Mint Mark quarter dollar.
And what's this one here? Oh, my. It's got to be more. It's going to be $500,000 probably. No. Oh, no. Here we go.
Quarter selling for anywhere from a $900,000 of dollars to potentially more for well-preserved, uncirculated specimen.
That's a 1985 Philadelphia Mint. Buy a price guide, please. I don't believe this. I cannot believe they actually said the values that was said in this. I mean, even if you screw up, even if AI gets it wrong or whatever, you why would it go that high? You know, this is manipulated text, canned, whatever. I mean, they've got software out there where you can do this. I can do it with my own videos. I can steal videos and redo it and add my own information. This is flat out lying, trying to confuse people. I mean, that's all this is. There's just no other way of thinking about it. It's almost like someone thinks it's a hobby to make a joke out of this, to make a joke out of our hobby, numismatics and coin collecting and coin roll searching. This really can hurt because people think that they have something. We literally have somebody call on the phone demanding to talk to me, said they've got $1 million coin, and were rude and would not listen to us whatsoever, wouldn't let us tell them what the value is or where to find the value. And they're several states away. This stuff is it's very stressful. It's hard on the guys that work for me because someone calls up on the phone and acts like that. It is very sad to do that to a coin shop. You know, I do these videos and I tell you, buy you a 2024 Mega Red Book. Buy you a price guide. Quit watching videos. Quit looking for your values on air values on eBay or Etsy or any other place. That's not where you find values. You literally got to stop watching videos on values and things like that if they're not from reputable sources. This is not reputable at all. And it had the channel itself has over 6,000 subscribers at this point and probably growing. I could probably look into metrics and see that they're growing. You know, and it's got comments. This video itself has 114,000 views. 114,000 views. Thanks for watching my latest video. Please buy a price guide. Please share this video. Thanks for watching. Please like, share, and comment, and have a great day.